Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. Welcome to my participation in the Burns' dynasty here on the PS3. I chose the Duke Blue Devils, and I'm going to get right into it here. Not going to do recruiting because this is an online dynasty, and I don't want to tip my hand to the others playing what I'm looking at. So we're going to go right into gameplay of week one here. We got Florida International. Now, if you were in my session and my live stream yesterday, I edited up some of this video, so this might look very familiar to you if you joined in on that behind-the-scenes editing deal we had going on. But if you didn't, this is brand new. So I was very close to choosing Duke in my Xbox 360 dynasty, my offline dynasty, which eventually became the UMass building project dynasty. I was very close to picking Duke in that, but it seemed like a little too easy. With an 83 overall. Well, so I chose them for this online dynasty that the Burns is putting on. If you haven't seen his channel, his videos, do check them out. He's also in my PS3 dynasty, so we kind of return to the favor. Here we go, handing off to Scott right up the middle for, well, close to first down yardage. It'll be second and inches. That turns into third and inches. The handoff to Scott again, and he'll have a first down. And wait a second, whoa, what's he doing pitching to a lineman? Harding gets that pitch and luckily hangs onto it, the big lineman. Did not mean to do that. This was my first game on PS3 on NCAA, well, ever. I picked this up to play with my viewers and play in this dynasty, and I'm still getting used to the controls, and well, I can't blame that one on the controls. I throw it right to Cheeseboro. Cheeseboro? When I first saw that name, I'm like, Cheeseburger? Cheeseburger. I liked it so much, I threw the ball to him again. Yeah, Cheeseboro with another pick. Ooh, not good early on. Here is Duke with a couple turnovers here and a pitch to a lineman that they survived. So still nothing. And oh, way to use your head there, buddy. Next time, let's try the arms, okay? Wow, that's just, well, you can't make that up. Second and 10, thrown to Deaver. He will catch the ball. Used his hands. Nice, way to go, buddy. So Sean Renfrey looking to throw. He's going to roll to the right and finds Vernon. First down, did he catch it? Yep, he did, okay. Third and four later in the drive. Renfrey is assessing the situation and finding Crowder for a first down. Okay, I like this. We're getting a couple first downs, getting things moving. He gets jammed at the line. Look at that. A couple moves he had to make to get free. And when he does, Renfrey finds him for a first down. We're going to go running play to Scott again. He bounces outside the hash just a bit. 7-yard pickup, second and three. And we're going to go play action this time. Renfrey over the middle to Vernon. He's wide open. I like this. Okay, red zone time. I'm not so great in the red zone, I tell ya. It's long strikes or, yeah, I don't know. Red zone offense stalls on me quite a bit. It doesn't matter if it's against the computer or against an opponent. I tend to psych myself out a little too much where I go to the pass game when I should be running. We'll see what happens here. Anyway, shotgun. First and 10. Renfrey to throw. There we go, Vernon. Turns around and catches that one before getting popped. It's first and goal. Let's see a replay on that. Again, jammed at the line. They're jamming a lot of my wide receivers right in the bump and run coverage here, but he gets to that second layer, turns around, makes a tough catch. So that'll set us up really nice with a first and goal here. Florida International taking that play a little hard, but that's okay. Game's early on here still. First and goal, handoff to Scott. He goes in untouched. There we go. That's what we want from our red zone offense. Efficiency, get on in there, get a lead before the first quarter is over. So Duke scores first, up 7-0. Get the home crowd behind you, get the Blue Devil rocking here. Yeah, that's right. Okay, so Duke's got a lead on this real short run. And we go to the simulation here. Florida International comes right back and scores themselves. So it's 7-7 early in the second quarter. Sean Renfrey looking to find Crowder again. That's a nice little play for 8 yards. I like that little crossing pattern. It works well most times. Second and two. Look out, Renfrey, but he does get it off to Vernon in time for first down. Okay, that's another nice play. Gonna run the ball here. Try to get a nice balance. Scott's gonna run hard for 6. And things are looking pretty balanced on this drive so far. So good. Renfrey to Deaver. Oh, he pushes that man right off of him. Let's see a replay on that. Looks like he gave him a good stiff arm here. He catches the ball. He turns around, lowers his head, and then boom! Puts 32 right to the ground. Oh, I love it. Okay. So, third and four. Let's not stall out here. What do we got? Renfrey to throw over the middle. Ooh, could have been picked off. It's fourth down. So, unfortunately, we have stalled out the drive. We're going to go for it on fourth and four, though, because it's kind of like between. Obviously, it's out of field goal range. Oh, Vernon makes a tough catch on fourth and four. And we've got the first down. Nice job there. I'm liking his hands at most points here. So handing off to Scott to the left-hand side. He's going to spin to no avail. It's third and five. And over the middle to Crowder. He makes the catch. Gets popped. All good now, though, as they get another first down. Third and seven here out of the shotgun. Renfrey. Oh, boy. Had a touchdown if he leads him just a little bit farther. Instead, he throws it behind him. And they got to settle for a field goal. So it's 10-7 at the half. Duke has the lead. You know, not impressive, but it's a lead. So into the third quarter, Renfrey throwing to the right side. Crowder's going to make the catch before going out of bounds. Third and two. That doesn't work. Fourth and three, they're going to go for it. Pass over the middle, and oh boy, this was tough. This was a turning point here. Kind of a tough spot to decide to go for it, but I thought we could get it. We don't. And of course, the big fear here is that this leads to momentum going the other way. And as we go to the sim, that's exactly what happens. Florida International comes back and takes the lead with a touchdown of their own, 14-10. Okay, maybe we should have punted in that spot. But hey, second guessing always is 20-20, right? Oh, what a great catch. No! Oh, he laid out, but he could not catch it. That would have been huge. Needed that one. Renfrey over the middle to Deaver will make that catch. So they do get first down yardage. Moving forward, Renfrey's now close to 200 yards passing, only hitting at about a 50% completion rate, though. Over the middle to Gattis. Gattis will make the catch. Second and three. Turns into third and 10 now. Renfrey's going to go to the sideline. Yes, Vernon's got it. Let's go back and retake this lead here late in the third quarter. Renfrey to throw over the middle. Wide open is Vernon. There we go. And he absorbs the hit without fumbling. That's even better. Under a minute left in the third quarter now, and Crowder's wide open. He's gonna, oh wow, nice little nifty move to fall forward and get the first down. Jamison Crowder goes up over 100 yards receiving with that play. Hand off now to Scott, who's going to fight forward close to the goal line, getting down to five. Second and three. Here we go to my pass play again. This is probably where I should just trust the running game, but instead I throw into double coverage and Leonard picks it off. Uh-oh. Well, instead of taking the lead, we get thwarted at the goal line. I really need to just run the ball in those cases. That's just bad coordination by me on the offensive play calling. I'll take credit for that one. So anyway, Florida International, of course, comes back all the way down the field and scores and puts the pressure on. Because now it's fourth quarter and we're down 21-10. Renfrey's got a press here. And unfortunately, he doesn't have enough air under this ball. It's intercepted, and now we've got big-time problems. Pressing to try to get back in the ball game. Well, we do stop them, at least, and it really doesn't take much time off the clock. So it's still 21-10, and Renfrey's got a chance to do something. Vernon, oh, he's had a really good game, but he got alligator arms big-time on that play. Got scared of the hit and dropped the ball. Fourth and five, Deaver does hang on to continue this drive. Okay, well, let's see what we can do with it. As coach is happy about it. All right, so fourth and seven, though. This is real interesting here. Going to have to convert on fourth down again. Vernon again is hit, and the ball is dislodged. Turnover on downs. Florida International scores again, and that's going to be the killer because it's now 28-10. When our offense gets going, Crowder! Oh, what an amazing catch, and he gets a foot down in bounds. Laid all out for that one, sacrificing the body. Here, Gattis is going to make the catch and get in the end zone. So like I said, that last turnover on downs and the corresponding touchdown after it from Florida International is a killer. Because now, instead of down a score, we're still down two, I believe. But a nice pass to Gattis nonetheless to get into the end zone. Why is it that my Duke offense operates best when they're down 14 points or more? That's not a good thing. So anyway, they celebrate the score, but it's a little premature here. Gonna go for two, and it's 28-16. Could make it a 10-point game, but no! Hunt is gonna pick it off, and not only is he gonna pick it off, he is gonna go all the way back for 2 points the other way. And eventually, Hunt will get into the end zone, and there you go. They get the 2 points. All around, just major malfunctions for this Duke offense. We're going to have to retool after this one. So a 30-16 loss on our home field. Very disappointing. not very much expected. Duke fans, rightfully so, not happy with the performance. So, well, you know, it's a dynasty. It's not one game. We'll have to right the ship, get things going. Jake Medlock, your player of the game for Florida International. But got to shake it off. It's a loss. Whatever. It's in the past. So we look to advance. And like I said, this is the Burns, his dynasty, and I'm just a part of it. But you see the others who are involved. It's a pretty good crowd, having a good time. And we'll be back with week 2 very soon. We'll see you guys. Thanks for watching.